Welcome to the History Hunter. Welcome to our small adventures with the World War II time frame. We are metal detecting. We're in the forest where the Germans had some activity, and our main target is to see if we can find proof of that. We are actually down in a hole. You can see that, this hole we're sitting in. We haven't got a clue of what we can find, but we definitely know what was here. So let me show you on a small diagram. So that's our target. Try to find anything at all at this German Atlantic Wall fortification position. To help us out, we have this beautiful Makro Multi Kruzer metal detector. It's a very handy machine. Packs down very small, lightweight, waterproof. A lot of programs for both beginners and amateurs, and this is actually a beginner machine if you want to, and you can use it for several years. It's got very difficult programs if you want to do that, but it's fantastic. We have the Nokta pointer, beautiful pin pointer with a replaceable tip there. You can adjust the gain in the back, and you have the loudspeaker there, and you have a strong LED there to help you out if the holes get very deep. We have our digging spades. We have our first little target down here. My son is using the pin pointer, and we haven't got a clue. There's something special going on here because all the positions are so absolutely not here. They should be here. There's something there. I can see it. No? Oh, let's put it up here. What's that thing there? Is that a milk bottle? Yeah, that's the aluminum cap for the 2-liter milch bottles that the Germans had here. They had to drink milk as well. All right, not a good start, but that's at least a little start. You know, what can you expect? Looks like barbed wire pieces. That will be everywhere here. They had lots of perimeters around their installation, so there'll probably be a lot of that today. Just discovered something here. Let me see something if I can show it to them. Right there, there's a depression in the ground. Something's going on there. So we're gonna work ourselves way over there. Here we have a little thing that is very, yeah, there, also there. What are they, son? Coal, yeah, that's pieces of coal. That means that there was definitely something here that they needed to heat, because they would heat the bunkers and the barracks with the coal, the coal, and they would give off signals. So why can't we find the installations here? See here, actually one of the ovens. We call them bunker ovens because they're always attached to either a bunker or a barrack. See, that's a ceramic bowl piece there. That is down here. So where is the openings to this crappy bunker system here? We can't find them. And you see, we are pretty deep down here. It's like in a huge dug thing here, but there's nothing to see. All right, we got something going on here. Do you want to take it up, son? Something here. What is that? You can do it. Oh.
What is that?
Well, that seems to be a wrench. You see that? That's a tool. That's a tool. That is probably a tool from one of the guns that was here. I like that. It's gotta be. It can't. Yeah, it looks like a tool. You see that? Wow, exciting. See that there? That is actually one of the gun placements. There's a massive trench coming down here from the hillside. You can see it here. But the strange thing is that there is nothing in the ground, not one thing whatsoever. Was hoping for maybe a small cartridge or some gear that was blown up, whatever. But oh, there's almost nothing at all. I'm gonna go a little bit in between these artificially planted trees here. This is a forest that they will harvest. You can see the trees are kind of lined up like this, and that will probably be cut down in a few years. I'm just gonna check a little bit around here and see if there could be something. It is so strange. There are like four huge gun emplacements. We know there are 3 to 4 dug down bunkers, which we absolutely cannot find. The forest's been growing for like 70 plus years. And all we can find are the German Mauser or German machine gun cartridge. Isn't that strange? Huh? Just the tiny small cartridges, but I'm happy with that actually. So the back will reveal the date and stuff like that. At least we're finding something. You know the Atlantic wall fortification positions are, oh, it's very, very sensitive now. It's on very high gain, but you know, I can ground balancing it one more time. 1, 2, 3. Now it's ground balanced. The soil changes when you go around, you know, but on these positions, it's pretty interesting because you never know what you're going to find. But this position has been forgotten for, you know, nobody talks about it, nobody knows it's here. So it's just a matter of if you're having a lucky day or not. So actually, just further down here, there are some massive bomb craters, and I was hoping that we could bring a magnet to do something there. It'd be really fun to see if we can find shrapnel pieces from the huge bombs that the Allied dropped here, trying to get to the Germans. Huh? Something here? Very good signal, son. Take away the cow crap. Something is absolutely here. Let's check that out. Just a very, very small fragment of something on the surface. Oh wait, there's something here. There's more, son. Oh, just some more fragments. No. Is that, son? No. I will check it out. If you're crazy enough to eat these, well, you have a headache for many days. And you could even die. So don't eat them, don't touch them, just leave them alone. There are some huge pieces of metal laying around here. In this massive ditch, let me show you where I am. See here, like 2 meters down below. And everything here is covered with metal on the bottom, but the trees has fallen down, so there's nothing we can do. Not our lucky day, is it? Another, that looks like brass actually. Is that a brass band for a projectile? Ooh, that looks very much like a... That is not your regular random brass piece out here. I'm definitely gonna check that out. Seems like there's something here and there. But we'll check it out. See here, this is a bit frustrating. More coal coming up from the ground. But we can't find the bunker entrances. They're down just underneath our feet, but we just can't find them. What is going on here? So much quieter down here in this forest area. And there's some cable laying around. It is so much more quiet. It's so windy on the top there. I have to say, really, I feel privileged to be able to do this. And it is thanks to a lot of you beautiful people out there who support us on Patreon and PayPal that we can go out, do some road trips, do some research, travel to locations. And hopefully, not always, but hopefully find stuff to share with all of you. So this time seems like it's kind of like a dead end, but you never give up. You do your best and only time will tell of what the result will be. But without the beautiful support we get from you, it will be quite impossible to do. So if you want to check out the possibility to become a supporter of our work, you can check out the videos in the beginning of each month, the giveaway videos, and can see how you can support our work, and you can actually end up getting some of our World War II dioramas with genuine artifacts from the Second World War. So check them out in the beginning of each month. That gun emplacement is filled with water. Too bad, I would like to go down there, but I can't. You get wet, and I don't want to get wet right now. This is very close to where there should be opening for a bunker, which you cannot find, which is under there somewhere. Because why are there pieces of coal, pieces of cast iron ovens, and this thing here in the middle of the forest? That's because there was human activity here, but we can't find the main installments, which are the underground bunkers. You can see them in the photos as round circles and square circles. That's the openings of the underground complexes, but we're giving up. 85. We have 85. Any higher bids? Where is it? Can it be a big part? Could it be that elusive huge? Oh, wow! Excellent! It is unopened! Are you kidding me? Look at this sun! A field ration unopened! Wow! That is a long time since we found that. You see that? It's not open. Holy. That is. It's aluminum or aluminium, whatever you want to call it, but it's unopened. Woo! A soldier's ration can. Unopened. Oh, that is fantastic. Oh, I love that. Just imagine, this thing was meant for a soldier during the Second World War when he was serving his duty here at this gun location, and now it's just here in the ground. Wow, and it's never been opened. Do you want to eat that, son?
Give me.
Give it to me, he says. Oh, this is going to be cool. Maybe we should open it. Maybe we should open it on camera, huh? Shall we? Yeah, we take it back and we'll make a separate video of that. That would be cool. Opening a field ration box from the Second World War. Watch out for that video. We will definitely do that. But we have to need gas masks. That will probably smell terrible. Cool. Seems like maybe one of the last items here. That's a wooden tip practice munition. That is actually very rare. And that's in the field here, next to the complex. Yeah, I'll check that out. It's definitely wartime. With the wooden tip, you can actually see the rest of the wood here. That is very, very rare. Wow. So, where is it? I really got frustrated there in the end. Powerful winds, it was really kind of getting nasty out there. It started to rain. We lost the camcorder, which I'm holding. That actually just, I don't know what happened to it, just went bananas. The GoPro camera was out of juice. And the mobile phone was actually in the forest about 200 meters away. So I looked for that for an hour. So that's how it goes. As you saw, there are these features around there. You see some depressions in the ground. You can definitely see the trench systems around there. We think we found at least two of the gun positions. And basically, I thought we would find, you know, lots of pieces. They guarded a very special Luftwaffe investment in the area. And actually, in the end, we did find a couple of 50 caliber tips. So, well, I don't know. Something, there should have been more there. I can't explain why there isn't. But definitely, in the end, as you saw, we started to find items that's a bit away from the forest area and the gun placements, but we think you're gonna like that. But that's gonna be another video, because we're actually gonna go back. I actually also forgot the beautiful little unopened field ration box. So, oh, total mess up. And well, this video just proves
that this is not easy. If you think it's a walk in the park, just go out and metal detect your park and find little coin, well, it's not. It's basically like 8 out of 10 times research, travel, a lot of work behind what we do, and also a lot of failure. We're not afraid to show that, but it's not that interesting. But in this occasion, I think it's going to be good in the end, but we have to get back there to be able to fulfill and do the proper end of this adventure. Nevertheless, it was fun to have you come along, and please watch our video, subscribe, share, comment, hit that little notification bell. And if you watch our videos in full, that will help us out really, really well. Well, there were no machine guns or hand grenades or huge guns there, but we will definitely surprise you in the next one when we get back there. So thanks for joining us. Stay safe, keep smiling, and we will definitely see you later in the hunt for the German WW2 gun location.